Hi, welcome to discussion right here. So we're trying to solve the equations. Now when you hear the word solving, it means you want to figure out what the x equals to, right? So basically you have to remove anything that's around the x. So far I see there's a 3 beside it. Now, as you can see, the 3 is multiplied to the x, right? So if you want to remove the 3, you're going to have to do something that's called the opposite, okay? So what's the opposite of multiplying? It's the dividing. So that means you had to divide the 3 away from the x. So if I'm going to show you all the work here, which I would, then you will just simply divide 3 to both sides. So negative 9 over 7 right here, if you divide it by 3, you can actually just put divide by 3 here if you want, okay? Now this will cancel. Now, it's not the 7 over 3, it's the 9 over 7 divided by 3. Now, sometimes it looks kind of confusing, but technically when you divide, if you take a fraction, if you divide by another number, you can actually just pretend that 3 is just down here, okay? It's actually negative 9 over 7, the original fraction, and there's a 3 right beside the 7. It's a denominator because you're dividing it, okay? So you're left with just the x on this side, and it's 9 over 3 times the 7 here. Or you can figure out the work between 7 and the 3, which is 21, and then you will have to simplify it at the end, which is 9 over 21 will give you 3 over 7. So it's negative 3 over 7. And that will be your final answer, which is right here. Now, sometimes the people don't like the idea where you have to divide both sides by the 3. So what we can do is we can do something that's called a cross multiplying. So let's try this question one more time. Negative 9 over 7 equals to 3x, right? So if you have two fractions, it doesn't have to be fractions, it's two different terms on either side of the equation, which is the equal sign here. What you can do is you can actually do something that's called the cross multiplying. So the cross multiplying meaning that if you pretend this is 3x, technically there's a 1 underneath. What you can do is you can take this 3 here and you can multiply it to the bottom down here. It's called a cross multiplying because if you're going to multiply, you have to go across. Now you can go downwards, you can go upwards, you can go this way or this way. But remember, you want to keep the x by itself. So we're not going to touch the x, we're just going to move the 3 down this way. So the 3 will be multiplied to the 7. So you're going to end up with exactly the same number and exactly the same answer, which is negative 3 over 7. Okay? Just two different methods for you to choose from. Thanks for watching.